So we've got a different arrangement now with this Hager socket. We go neutral, CPC with the earth symbol, CPC and the line conductor. So we'll again split the two CPCs across there, two neutrals and two line conductors, and they're all side by side. This contactum one, okay, has line, nothing here to connect to, neutral and only one CPC terminal, and in that case we would have to put the both CPCs into the same termination. I prefer socket outlets that allows us to split the two CPCs across there. I'm going to double these cables over. I'll do that off camera. I'll just show you about the length of those conductors. So this time we've come down through the box, so our length needs to be 50 to 70 mil longer than the box in this direction. Okay, so we're going to make sure we're crucial with that, and I like this one when it's this way to be nearer the 70 mil. So I'm going to do that approximately 70 mil longer than the box for all the conductors, and then I'll prepare these conductors off camera, and then we'll just look at actually connecting them into the socket outlet and getting them tight. So I've prepared the ends of my conductors using the same technique as I did before. I dropped in a conductor, I checked its depth, I practiced one and then dropped it in. And what I noticed was that the neutral and line depth is a lot shallower than the CPC. So when I've made off the doubling over of the CPCs, it is larger than that of the line conductor in this case, as well as the neutral. So CPCs go in further into the termination than the live conductors, line and neutral. So we're gonna pop those in. So again, let's start with the neutrals. Okay, so we'll start with the neutrals. This time, yep, I'm gonna still go one on top of the other. So I'm gonna position one on top of each other. The screws are back already. So they've gone in. Okay, you can't see any copper. Might be difficult for you to see from that angle, but you can't see any copper. And I'm gonna tighten those up. Again, when you're in the workshop, I don't recommend you're trying to keep out the way of a tripod in order to do it. In we go, get those nice and tight. So I've got the first ones. Let's do the line conductors next. I'm going to untangle them from within the socket. So I'm going to dress them round so they're untangled. I'll do the line conductor next. Lay one on top of the other, like so. And then drop those two in. And again, keep some pressure in order to terminate those tight. So saying on my videos, the one thing I never seem to do is wear my glasses. I'm using the force. So my two line conductors are in place, and now CPCs, let's dress them to suit. CPC terminal there, I'm gonna hold it in with a little bit of pressure. Tighten that one off. Okay, and then we'll tighten this one off into position like so. More little half a turn on that maybe. Okay, right, so they're in again. So you can see there that it sits longer than the box, which is crucial to me, and they'll spread out within the box. Often DIYers and early learning stage students cut them super short. It's not a problem in my workshop because my learners will say, what do I do if I cut the conductors too short? Take out the conductors, put a new fresh set in, and you go again. So we're gonna do exactly the same as we did before. We're gonna position it into place. So I'm gonna move them round. So I know they sit in nicely. I'm gonna crush it down into position. I'm gonna lift it back off, and I'm gonna check tighten these terminations in order to see that they're tight. Yep. And then obviously that can go down and we can fix it down using the appropriate 3.5 machine screws.